Hello guys, it is me, Sirio, and today I am going to be doing a gurguit deck profile. And I'm super excited to be back, and without further ado, let's get started with the deck profile. So the starting Vanguard, we are still running the Unite starter. With his skill, it is Generation Break 1, an act, you can put him to the soul, you can look at the top 3 cards of your deck, and Superior Common to Rearguard Circle, and it gets plus 2,000, you shuffle the deck. And it requires for you to activate Unite. So the reason why this card is actually good is because it build fields really early, and also the fact that during your turn, when you're either on Heavenly Law or Scourge Point on first drive, depending on which situation you're in, with this card you can just generate field a lot better, and it can also fix calls, it can generate soul. Even during late game, if you haven't used anything and you need to call field, and you haven't used this card yet, you can use this card to call more field. Next up for grade 3 lineup, we are running the one and only 3. Sunrise Midnight Gurguit. 3 Golden Holy Sword Gurguit, and 2 Salvation Lion Blonde Ezel Scissors. So we're running Ezel because Link Joker is still running around and Chaos Breaker is slowly becoming tier 1. And there's also the possibility of running into Messiah in competitive tournaments. And the reason why I'm running this is because this deck hates Link Joker, and if you ride into Ezel, you can actually make your opponent panic, because usually people will expect you playing pure Gurguit if they see that you're playing Gold Paladin. But with the Ezel tech, you also get to unlock a lot of things, and you have more options in terms of striding if you are stuck on Ezel. And it's not a bad thing if you're stuck on Ezel, it's not. It's preferable to be on one of the 6 Gurguits, but being on Ezel, especially during a Link Joker matchup, Chaos Breaker especially, is actually really useful. Next up, running the new Gurguit, Golden Holy Sword Gurguit. With his skill, he has 2 different skills. So his first one is Generation Break. Continuous Generation Break 2, Unite. All of your units get the intercept ability, and when your Vanguard attacks, this unit can intercept. When your Vanguard is being attacked, this unit can intercept from the back row. And it's all of your rear guard, sorry. This is good because you can intercept with back row stuff, and also the fact that if you don't have enough counterboss to use this defensively, you can still use this pretty defensively, especially when you're going to be calling rear guards rested with his skill, which going into his next skill, it is his stride skill, which is counterboss soul boss 1. When your G unit is placed onto this unit, you may pay the cost. If you do, you look at the top 4 cards of your deck, Superior Call into Rearguard Circle, shuffle your deck. Then, if the called unit has the Unite ability, you call the top card of your deck in the rest position. So, the reason why this card is actually a lot more aggressive than the old Gurguit is because this thing can trigger Unite very easily, especially in early game when you need to build field and you're rushing like no one ever will with Heavenly Law. It is still actually really good, which is why I'm running it at 3. And in certain matchups, you're either going to be on old Gurguit or the new Gurguit, depending on if you had a consistent hand, if you're being rushed. It all just depends on the matchup. Which, going into the old Gurguit, with this Generation Break, you can Superior Call cards from the deck to Guardian Circle during your opponent's battle phase, which is actually really good because Superior Perfect Guarding is a thing. Also, the fact that with his stride skill, yes, you can buff up your rear guards, but it isn't as good as this card in terms of aggression, because this can trigger Unite. But if you need to be on more of defensive Vanguard, this is the card you want to be on. I'm running 3-3 because I want to see this card actually a lot more consistent, and I already see this card enough consistently, and usually in matchups where I needed to play a lot more aggressive, I needed to be on this card, I was usually on the old Gurguit instead of the new Gurguit. So I'm running 3-3 because it actually helps a lot. Okay. Moving on to grade 2s, I am running 3 Henriness, 3 Bullergall, 2 Pwyll, 1 Paramore, and the thing that actually did come back to the deck, 2 Marcia. So, I'm running Henriness because with his skill you can counterboss Soul Boss 1, and when he's placed in Rearguard Circle, you may pay the cost. If you do, you can look at the top 3 cards of your deck, Superior Call into Rearguard Circle, bottom deck the rest, and if you have a Vanguard with Gurguit, the called unit addition, you both gain plus 3. I'm running this because this is a lot more aggressive than Paramore, and you're already generating enough soul with this deck. You don't really need to worry about soul blasting that much. Even when you're on old Gurguit, you'll still have a decent amount of soul to be able to use your Generation Break. And also the fact that being able to be very aggressive on Glorious Reigning or on First Strike in general, as well as being able to call units and they gain a power buff, it's still really good. I'm running Balurgal because he's a free 14k attacker on Unite when it attacks the Vanguard, because 14k attackers are really good. Vivia's behind a 7k booster, it is immediately a 21k line, which is why I'm running it at 3. I bump pull down to 2, and the reason is because I'm still seeing it consistent enough, and the deck was also very counterbust heavy, which is why I needed to put back Marcy in the deck. And even with pull is still like a very good card, it's the MVP, because with this card and another card in the Grade 1 lineup, I have a potential of killing my opponent on first stride or rushing them down to a pulp. This is also a priority target in terms of attacking, in terms of your opponent going against this deck, because this card can do so much damage. With Marcia, it is a resist unit, so against decks like Chaos Breaker or Link Joker, Narukami, Kagero, Mega Colony, this is just like, ha, you can't do anything to me. And at the end of each turn, if you trigger Unite, you can put her to the soul and countercharge 1. That is why I'm running her at 2. Because the deck is still pretty counterboss heavy, and I felt like it needed a lot more countercharge. I'm running the 1 Paramore now, because Paramore is still pretty good. It gets plus 2k on Unite, and that's not GB restricted. So if you're rushing your opponent pretty early, you can use him to get plus 2 and just to punch the face. Also, with his skill, even though it is restricted to calling in the same column, it's not bad. Now, I might be getting rid of him and putting a third pull in. I'm still in that stages, but so far the deck has been working really well. And it's been working, and it just started to rain. Yippee-ki-yay. Ah, cards fell. No. Okay. Anyways, on to grade ones. So, I'm running in this deck 4 Lysias, 4 Jeffrey, and then the change I made was 3 Stride Fodder and 3 Horses. So, I am running a Lysia because being able to bottom deck something and give it 15k shield is pretty good, and giving this unit 15k shield on Unite. Also, it opens up rearguard circles and things like that. And because of this card, you can also perfect guard the Vanguard from the deck, so it still makes it an optimal defensive card. It's not bad. I like it a lot because I can also bottom deck rearguards that are being attacked, because it says when this unit is placed on Guardian Circle, Unite for the bottom decking thing, which is really good. And because if things like resetting Vanguards are attacking it, like an example of this would be your opponent's playing DP, they have a commander lore on the board, and they're going to punch a rearguard. You're like, okay, guard, unit is active, bottom deck it. Boom, right there. They cancel the attack out. The opponent basically wasted their attack, and it's pretty good. And it's pretty good for doing that. Also, Slangiflare can do the same, which is pretty good. Pretty good. Next up, I'm running 4 Jeffrey because the deck still needs the hand power a lot. I think that the deck still needs the hand power simply because the deck just runs low on cards in hand. And also the fact that because this deck does discard, and also I don't run Canarius because the discard hurts too much. So if you guys are wondering why I don't run Canarius, the reason is because the discard hurts. And with Jeffrey, I can keep a consistent hand, and also helps me recover. And also the fact that with Holy Sword of Heavenly Law, I do have to discard early, which isn't really good in terms of like getting cards back in your hand, especially when you're playing against heavy rush-based decks, or Luard, like all the meta clans, and being able to just replenish your hand is super nice. I'm running 3 Stride Fodder now. 3. Because I felt like I was already striding enough. The deck was striding consistently, and I was hitting Gurguit enough, so I didn't really feel like I needed to run that at 4 now. And I don't need to guarantee my ride onto Gurguit like I did last profile, so I can just keep running it at 3. Next up, I am running Horsa now. I bumped it up to 3, because with Horsa's skill, Unite, when your other unit is placed in rearguard circle, you may pay the cost if you do. This unit and the other unit in the same column as this unit both gain plus 2. So, his number 1, rulings are, this card, when you trigger Unite, its Unite will go off. Number 2, if you call over it, the unit in front of it will still gain the power. Also, who doesn't like getting 15k on this thing and making this a 22k booster? It is very possible, because of Pwill and other things that call, like, the really superior call, which is why I like running this card. It is also a really good aggressive card. I've also pushed out Knight Rose to where I'm going to either rush them and make them have no cards in hand, or I'm going to rush you and you die, or I'm just going to make you use your resources to kill this card because this is another priority target. So we're running that like that. Next up, for grade zeros, we're still running four heals. Five stand triggers this time. I'm still running four Jerry because the deck does need to countercharge and catch Gull. And then I am running seven crit for Scarface Lion, one SP just for good luck, and Flame of Victory. So, I am still running Catch Call because the fact that this card, I can fix calls. Also, if I call the top card of the deck rested from Gurguit's skill, Catch Call skill will go off and I can immediately fix the calls. If I'm an old Gurguit, I can actually trigger Unite with this card if I superior call its rear red circle from deck. I can also make Horse a ramp into a shoot ton of power with this card, which is actually really, really good, which is why I still like it. I decided to bump, though, I changed the trigger lineup down to 5 stand 7 crit because I felt like the deck wasn't being aggressive enough, especially now in a meta where you need to be running a bit more crit heavy decks, which is why I'm still running 4 Scarface Lions, 3 Flame of Victories. Again, I am running Jerry because the deck still needs the counter charge and it's really nice to keep a consistent soul. And I'm running 4 heals because why not? I'm running Scarface Lion because it's Gurgle crit and why wouldn't you want to draw cards? If you call that instead of Jeffrey, you still get a draw. You call this from the top card of your deck with the new Gurguit, then you can use the skill, and it'll actually be a lot more useful, which is why I'm running it, as well as Catch Call and other things like that. So that is my grade zero lineup. So because this is Gurguit, as well, RG Zone is actually pretty weird. So I'm running 4 Heavenly Law, 4 Glorious Reigning still, 1 SP for good luck, 2 Mithril Ezel, 1 Sunrisery Radiant Sword, 1 Scorch Point, 1 Sea Breeze, and for G Guardians, I am running 1 Rhea, and we can find space, that'll do, I think, and 2 Slamy Flare. So, okay, we're just going to talk about the G-Guardians later. So, I'm running 4 Heavenly Law because with his skill, once per turn you can counterblast 1 and choose a face-down Heavenly Law from G-Zone and turn it face-up. And you just choose a card from your hand and discard it. This unit gets 2 abilities. Number 1, Unite. When this unit attacks, you may pay the cost. Well, no, it's when this unit attacks, you look at the top 4 cards of your deck and superior call 1 2 from among them, and then top 7, and then you Spirit Call 1 to rear guard circle, and then you shuffle your deck. And the second skill is, this unit and all of your other units gain plus 2,000 for every face-up Gurguit in the G-Zone. Now, the reason why this is good is because usually ramping once with plus 2k to everything and getting an additional attack is not bad. It helps push for damage. Number 2, if you use this second time in a row, if you have the hand advantage too, and you have like a horse on the board, sorry about shaking the camera, but if you have a horse on board, basically, you can make that horse up. Let's say you triggered Unite, okay, +2/+2. Great with skill. Okay, the unit in front of Horsa and Horsa have gained +8 in total because of that, which makes Horsa and Poil really good as well, because with Battle Phase Calling, you can make this card a lot better. And because I can kill on first stride with this card now, there's more of a potential. This card right here, it's still really devastating and really, really good. And people do need to watch out for that card. Next up, I am running still 4 Glorious Reignings because Glorious Reigning is a very strong finisher. I'm running it because being able to call up the 2, like being able to blow board again is really strong, and also being able to ramp horses up is really strong. Being able to get at least 5 attacks is really strong. Unless you know you can't punch face or anything like that, then yeah, you know, that's pretty unfortunate, but still. It blows board. If you Spirit Call 3 or more, then you Soul Charge 1, Counter Charge 1. Even though that is a mandatory effect, it actually refreshes resources, which makes this card really good. That's why it's pretty expensive. And also the fact that, who doesn't like getting more columns? Fresh columns. There's horses that you haven't boosted yet, you know, you're just like, okay, call. Cool, I called 3 units. One behind the Vanguard. Doesn't matter the Vanguard attack. +6, +6, +6, +6. Doing my thing. Soul charge 1, counter charge 1. Catch go, skill goes off. Bottom deck it. You do your ramping. In power. Really good. This is also a very good card to put a lot of pressure on your opponent. Late game and you know, second turn stride. And because of this card, now you don't need a G guard early to be able to get make this unit superior call 3 units. Because of this card. Good. Now I'm running the 2 Ezels. And I'm running the 2 Ezels because it's either if I have to Jesus, okay, cool, I Jesus them away. Doesn't matter, depending on which matchup. And also, I don't want to blow hand for the counter matchup against Link Joker, just so I can limit break and put myself in a worse position of less cards in hand and I can get rushed even more. That's not what I want to do. If I don't have a full field and I need to unlock, that's where this card comes in handy, which makes it really good. I like this a lot. Because with his skill, you can once per turn counter boss one and choose face down one of him, face up, face down from G-Zone, turn to face up. If you have a heart with Ezel, you pay the cost. If you do, you unlock everything. Then you look at the top 5 cards, your deck's Pier, Coleman, Rearward Circle. And that unit and this unit both gain the exact same power, the exact same original power of that unit that was Spirit Called. So you double the unit's Spirit Called with this effect's power, and this also gets the original power. So let's say if I use Ezel and I call Gurguit, Gurguit will gain 11k because that's his original power, and so will Ezel. If I call Flame of Victory, they both will gain 4k. If I call Blurgall, they both gain 9k. You get the drill. That's why I'm running it. It's not bad. Even if I get stuck on Ezel, I still have at least something to do instead of being stuck on the dog. Like you guys seen Team Counter Charges, you know, videos, if you guys watch Team Counter Charge, which you should. Yeah. I'm running the one Gurguit now, because this is just a finisher. This isn't really any more of a put pressure card. And you use this if you have low cards in deck, you have enough counter bust, and you are able to trigger unite without superior calling that much. So this is after you either use 4 of these, 2 of these, 4 of these, 2 of these, and you are really low cards in deck. That's what this card comes in handy for. Now, I'm wanting to run Scourge Point because Scourge Point is the other stride where if I don't have enough cards in my hand and I will put myself in a really bad position if I use Holy Sword Gurguit for first stride, I use Scourge Point for first stride because with Scourge Point I can superior call units and they will gain off 5k, which actually makes it pretty good. I like it a lot. It doesn't make the deck bad, it makes the deck good, I feel like, and also it just helps the deck a lot in terms of I need to recover. Now, you don't need to run the Mithril Ezel. I run it, I like it a lot, but I'm still contemplating on taking this out for more G-Guardians, because moving on to the G-Guardians after I explain Seabreeze. Seabreeze is Seabreeze, very self-explanatory. You don't need to worry. If your opponent decides to grade stock themselves on grade 2 without rewriting, you punish them for it. That's basically what Seabreeze is there for. But I'm debating to cut it for 2 more G-Guardians because this amazing card of 3 G-Guardians I run. So I'm running, boop, boop, 2 Golden Beast Flaming Flare, SP for good luck, and the 1 Rhea. I'm running Rhea instead of 3 Flaming Flare because I feel like getting the 5k shield without wasting your resources, wasting cards in your deck, even though you do get a bottom deck, but I'd rather be able to get a free 20k shield instead of bottom decking something and potentially getting a 20k shield and not having to overguard. That's why I like this at 1. I'm running 2 Slamming Flares because with Slamming Flare, I have a potential perfect guard because I'm running Alicia. I have a potential 30k now with Alicia getting updated. It's either 40k. Yes, it's either 40k or 35k shield, which makes this a lot better. And I can also bottom deck stuff and still consistently have cards in my deck. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this deck profile. Again, I'm still tweaking the deck up a little bit. I will be doing an updated profile if I feel like I need to, feel like this variation wasn't as good as the previous variation. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you click that like, subscribe, and comment down below to see what else deck profiles, because I can just ask members of my community to do deck profiles. Also, I'm rebuilding the ward, and I'm really close to finishing it, so if I finish it, we all know what's coming. Luard Diablo deck profile. Yeah. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you click that like, subscribe, and comment down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm glad to be back, and I'm going to be posting a lot more now. Without further ado, I will be saying goodbye now. Goodbye!